If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification. Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in advanced level where you are solving previous year ITJE questions on continuity. So in this lecture, we will be solving question number 4 and question number 5. Okay, then let's solve these questions. Now, if you come to question number 4, for every integer n, an and bn are real numbers, then the function given from R to R is given by, that means all integer R to integer R, that's right. So an plus this one, for x 2n to 2n plus 1, then 2n minus 1 to 2n. So this is a very funny thing, because if you do in 2n is here, so if you do 2n plus 1 is here, 2n minus 1 is here, if you think pi or pi multiple of that one, because you can remember these are odd multiples of n, 90 degree, these are even multiples. So you can say 2n minus 1, you can say 2n plus 1, so this can interchange. F is continuous, then what of the, then they are saying F is continuous. So the breakpoints are here, actually all these are breakpoints, 2n's, 2n plus 1, 2n minus 1, 2n plus 2. So whatever integer you are getting, you are changing from 1 to 1. So it is actually a different function for 2. One block is this one, 2n to 2n plus 1, another block is 2n. So this is, you can say, if this is one block, actually one quadrant, one, one. So if you move on one quadrant to one quadrant, so all these are boundary points, 2n, 2n minus 1, if you say 2n plus 1, then it will be 2n plus 2. So all these are boundary points. So all these points you have to check. So at x equal to 2n, if I check, so 2n minus 2n plus. So which one is 2n minus? 2n minus is this one I will be using. That means bn this one. So if I am using this one, then cos 2n pi is what? In this line, cos is always 2n pi. 2n pi is this line, because even multiple of n. 2, 4, 6. Here 1, 3, 4. You can recall that trigonometry when we have remember name. If I say 2n pi, then only this line from here to here. If I say n pi, then this entire line comes. So this is actually I am talking about in terms of 90 multiple. So we'll see. So it is 2n pi. 2n pi is, you are landing here. So here cos below is always 1. So it is bn plus 1. And your RHL 2n plus. 2n plus, you will come to this one. So here if you put sin 2n pi, what is the value of sin in this line? It is always 0. So it is an. So these two should be equal. And what is the value of function at that 2n? For 2n, you will be using this one. So an plus, so this is also an. So all three should be equal. So you can say these and these are equal. That means these and these are 1. So that means option B is correct. It was multiple correct. So you have to check for other points also. Next is 2n plus 1. For 2n plus 1 minus, it is this function. 2n plus 1 plus what function it will come? You will obviously that if this function will come, we'll see how we will bring it this one, because 2n plus 1 is not here. So let's see first 2n minus 1. So for 2n minus 1, we will be using this one. So here we will be using this one, 2n minus 1. Now what is this function? 2n plus 1 pi. So what is 2n plus 1? 2n plus 1 is always odd. Odd multiple of pi. So this is 0, 0, 1 into 180, 2 in, 3 into 180. Odd multiples. 2n plus 1 pi lands here. All even multiples of pi lands here. So here again sin value is 0, so it is 1. Now how to find 2n plus 1? For that one, if you want to find 2n plus 1, you put here 2n plus. This was 2n minus. So 2n plus was which one? So for that, you put n equal to n plus 1 here. If you put n equal to n plus 1, then you will get 2n plus 1 from here. Because this is true for all value of n, for all integers. So n can be n plus 1. So if you put n plus 1 in the second one, this was given. So if I put n plus 1, so what it will be? It will be bn plus 1 cos pi x, that is given as it is, and if you put n plus 1 here, n plus 1 into 2 minus. So it is 2n plus 2 minus 1. That is 2n plus 1. Here it will be 2 into n plus 1. That means 2n plus 2. You can see it is coming from one quadrant to another quadrant. That's it. So that means 2n plus 1 comes in this function. So if you put in this function limit 2n plus 1, so this will come instead of x. It will be 2n plus 1. So again, cos 2n plus 1 is here. So this quadrant, this is odd multiple of cos, so this is minus 1, that's why minus 1. So again, these two should be same because it was continuous everywhere. So if you do this one, that should be equal to minus 1. That means option C is wrong, because option C is given, it is plus 1. Now which one is left? 2n minus 1. So again, you have to check 2n minus 1. For 2n minus 1, 2n minus 1 minus 2n plus 1 plus. 2n plus 1 plus is obviously this one, 2n plus 1 plus. Again, 2n minus 1 minus you don't have. So for that again, you will put some n equal to n minus 1 in this equation, then you will get it. So this is your 2n plus 1, this function. Again, cos 2n minus 1 pi, it is minus 1. Now for this one, I don't know this function. This was the original function. Now if you put n equal to n minus 1, it will be n minus 1, this one.
in place of n, if you put n minus 1, then it is 2n minus 2, n minus 1, 2n minus 2 plus 1, so it is 2n minus 1. So now 2n minus 1 minus, little less than 2n minus 1 will come here. So if you put it there, 2n minus 1 minus will come here. Again, sine this quadrant, odd multiples of 180 is 0. So again, this and this is same. So again, D is correct. A will be wrong. I am not doing it again. You can check it at 2n plus 2. Plus 2n, 2n minus 2 minus. Both you check, you will find option A is wrong. So the correct option is B and D. These two are correct. Now if you come to question number 5. For every pair of continuous function G from 0, 1, such that the maximum of function from 0 to 1, maximum of fx is equal to maximum of gx. Their maximum values are same. But at what point they are maximum, that is different. But the height they will attain is same. It is not mandatory that they will raise at same level, same height. No, they can one can raise this much here and one can raise this much here. So their heights are equal. Then the correct statements are. So from here you have to see the options. Here it is always f square, g square, f square, g square, f square, g square, f square, g square. So if you take the first one or any one where you can, something f minus c, f plus c concept is coming here. If you take this side, if you take this one here, you can take some common also f minus c. So if I say this one, it is suppose alpha, it is alpha, this is beta. So it is alpha square minus beta square, then you can take here alpha minus beta into alpha plus beta, and then 3 you can take alpha plus beta, alpha minus beta. You can take alpha minus beta common is equal. That means alpha minus beta is equal to 0 or alpha plus beta equal to minus 3. From here you have to get some idea. Now if I take alpha minus beta, because the difference alpha minus beta means difference between these two functions fx and gx. So let me take another function hx, which is the difference between fx and gx. Now if you see, suppose this is 0, this is 1. Suppose this is my function f. So this is the height of f of x. And suppose this is the height of, suppose this is 1, okay. So this is the height of g1. So at what point it is x1, x2. So these heights are equal there because they are at any maximum, maximum values are equal. So at some point f maximum, suppose at x1 f is maximum, so it is f max at x1, this is g max at x g2. So these two values are equal, they have given maximum value. Now you, at x1, if you see this one, the value of hx, hx is what's difference between these and these. So g is here, this is gx1, this point is fx2. So what is f, this minus this, here it is positive. What is at this point h, the function that we defined, this minus this is negative because fx2 is below, gx2 is up, negative. Now from intermediate value theorem, if one portion it is positive and one portion it is negative, then we have already explained intermediate value theorem. At some point you will get the height to be 0. We have explained, suppose the function height is here positive, here negative. So between these two values, 0 is also a value. So the function will be somewhere, it will obviously cross that 0. So the obviously alpha minus beta, that hx is 0. That means this hx, fx minus gx, hx must be 0 at some point. That means hc must be 0 for some c between x1 and x2. So x1, x2 will be obviously between 0 to 1 because they are attaining height between 0 to 1 only. So your c is obviously between 0 to 1. So you will have, that means hc is 0. That means fc minus gc is obviously 0. This one we have proved. At some point z between. So you will choose those options where fc minus gc is a possibility, is a factor, because that is 0, you know, because that will satisfy that function. So if you see first one, here you have already seen either this 0 or this 0. So because option A is saying this 0, so option A is satisfying my conclusion. B and C will not give me this as a factor because you cannot take fc minus gc common. But in option D also you can take fc minus gc common because it is simply fc minus gc into fc plus gc. A square minus B square. So either this 0 or this 0 we have seen. So it will obviously satisfy. So option A and D are satisfy my conclusion. That is from intermediate value theorem. That's why A and D are the correct option.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.